In 2009, yeah, single asylum seekers received £42.13 a week. Yeah. That went down at that in October 2009 to £35.13. That means that they're actually forced to live on 55% of the income support level, which is deemed the poverty line for the rest of the population. It means they're unable to travel, they're unable to participate in many regular things in life. It really just gives them enough money to buy food, literally the basics in life. For others who don't receive any money at all, who are forced into destitution, essentially they're forced into so-called illegal working, and the jobs that they take are they're really exploited. Others who get this, there are some asylum seekers who get what's called hard case support, and they get £35 a week, but they don't receive any cash at all. They just receive a card, and they can only use that card in the major stores. They can't use it in the local stores. They have to use the likes of Asda, Tesco, you know, the big supermarkets. Most people who come here, they want to work. They just want to get out, get a job, and have a meaningful day. Because when they're down, when they're living, trying to live on £35 a week, and they're stuck in a one room, they're just like you would be yourself. They're just bored. They've got nothing to do, and it does result in depression and an increase in the level of mental health problems that asylum seekers suffer. It has been proven that the level of mental health problems rises, even from people who are fleeing torture and war. The level of mental health problems increases whilst here because of the system that they're being put through. The budget cuts that this government's proposed has meant that the housing budget, the Home Office housing budget, for asylum seekers will be drastically reduced. So that will see a decline in the standard of accommodation that's going to be offered to asylum seekers, which in some cases is already very poor.
If you're a single asylum seeker, you're going to get a one-bedroom flat or something.
You get a one-bedroomed room. You get one room in a multi-occupational house. So you share it with, you know, it can be up to 15 other single asylum seekers, depending on the property.
Do you think they're exploited by property owners? Do you think there are some property owners out there that are exploiting their circumstance? Is there any evidence to show that?
Obviously there is, but I think due to the budget cuts, you will see an increase in that, because property providers will be forced to seek cheaper properties. And whilst there may be reasonable and good standards in the current accommodation, that will inevitably decline as a result of the budget cuts. Asylum seekers are forcefully deported against their will to the place from where they originally fled, whilst they still consider themselves to be at risk of murder, torture.
That's quite a common occurrence.
It is, yeah. I mean, I don't have the figures on me, but the number, the level of deportations rises according to the political will of the politicians. At any point in time, anyone who's seeking asylum can be subject to detention. And again, that it's not written on their identity card, but it's written on a letter that they receive, and most correspondence they receive has written right across the top, you are liable to detention. So in some cases it can be quite arbitrary, and they can decide to detain a particular family. Legally, nobody should be held in detention unless they're about to be deported. But that isn't the case. Some people have been in detention for a long time, including children. I mean, it's very difficult to say why someone would end up in detention. People have ended up in detention. People can go down. They're within the system. They're going down. They're signing every week down in Liverpool, in Water Street. And then one day when they go to sign, they can just be taken and held. It certainly breaches the Convention Against Unlawful Detention. Of course, the government will argue that they, you know, that these people shouldn't be in the country, and based on their immigration status, they have reasons to detain them. But why is it wrong? Why should we withhold somebody? Why should we imprison somebody because of their immigration status? It's inhuman. Many of the support organisations and charities that provide support and advice and help on a practical basis to asylum seekers have had their budgets drastically cut. Many have lost 100% of their funding. So the level of support that will be available to asylum seekers will be drastically cut. So that will result in a large increase in the level of people being forced into super exploitative jobs, an increase in the level of poverty that asylum seekers suffer. It will also result in a higher level of destitution, as the number of asylum seekers fail to get support from the services that currently provide help and practical support to those who are currently destitute.